This is Blunt Squad TV. I am King Kuman C, and I'm right here in Zurich, Switzerland, standing in front of the Hiltl, which is the oldest vegetarian restaurant in all Europe. We're about to go talk to the owner and check out some of this good cuisine.
This is the house of Hiltl, and it has great variety of things we do. We have, for instance, a bar here. Upstairs is the cooking studio, where we give cooking lessons. We have a club, where the entrance is in the back door. Then we do caterings, takeaways, so it's a whole variety of vegetarian things.
How long has this been going on?
Since 1898, so that's 113 years now. My great-grandfather founded it, and I'm doing it in fourth generation.
What was your great-grandfather's name?
Ambrosius Hiltl. Like the place today, same name as me.
Hiltl. The oldest vegetarian restaurant in Europe, 113 years old. Did you say there was in the Guinness World Book of Records?
Yes, as the first vegetarian place in Europe.
Yeah. Wow, that's a record.
Yeah.
So you guys ready to roll and check out some good food?
Sure, let's go.
Let's roll.
Here we have 100 dishes, everything homemade and everything vegetarian. And what is also very interesting that 90% of our customers are part-time vegetarians. It's people who love vegetarian food, but they're not strictly vegetarian.
The most requested dish here would be what, do you think?
We have a lot of curries, Indian curries. The Indian dishes, they do very well. And the Asian dishes, Thai curries.
Could you show us an example of the Asian curry dishes?
Sure. That's some Indian curries here. Samosas, stuff like that. People love that paneer makhani, which is Indian cheese on a tomato sauce. People love this dish. The nuggets up here. Those. It's like chicken nuggets, but it's not chicken. It's just like.
Blunt Squad TV, he's about to show us how the food is really made and prepared, and now we're going to see firsthand how they get down.
The big, big chef. The big head chef, because he has big heads. 50 different nations working here. 50 different nations.
That's like the United Nations.
They come from all over. So she's from Finland. Neto. From Afghanistan. Germany, he's from Austria. This guy over there, he's from the United States. So he's from India. Colombia.
Yeah.
He does Asian hot with the fire. Some spices the chefs they use. And then they just get it here, and from here they prepare the dishes. So what's very important is the curry, you know, the different curries.
They've got their own curry.
Own curry mix. This is finishing tables. Here we finish our dishes. Like here you see, for example, spaghetti with tomato pesto. And here we put some herbs on. Or here we have a Moroccan dish, couscous. Or here, that's a best-selling item. The hot banana with spicy curry sauce and rice and fruit. That's very traditional. We do this since the 1960s. It can get pretty expensive up here, because you also have a menu, you know, you can order your dishes. So it's fine dining and vegetarian. A lot of people come here, tourists, they walk in, they think, well, it's a nice place, it's packed. And they eat, and they go out, and they don't even realize it was vegetarian. So that's okay with us.
There's one dish, like fried chicken strips.
Yeah.
And it tastes just like chicken in Texas.
It's a tandoor schnitzel over there. Our Twitter wall, and We have a lot of friends on Facebook. This is pretty good, 13,500 for Switzerland, for a restaurant. And we're very active on Twitter, over 1,000 followers. And so you can post everything you want. And if you're here in the restaurant and you think your coffee is not good, you just write it down and you post it and everybody sees it. This is not a problem for us because we check the coffee machine, we check the coffee and correct it right away.
This was 1952. And as you see at the time, there was only ladies working for us. There was about 30 ladies and one guy who managed them.
Two different cooking books. So this is where we do the cooking school. We do it with kids, as I said, with adults, and we just show people how we prepare our dishes. It's companies, families, schools. What's also very successful here is bachelor parties for ladies. So they like to cook, and afterwards they go to the parties in the club. That's also good, because if at the parties there's a lot of ladies, the men like it too. So this is win-win.
My name is Rolf. I'm the owner of Hiltl, and you are watching BluntSquadTV.